The Honourable Member for Concordia.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. This morning we heard firsthand the heartbreaking stories of how fentanyl and carfentanyl have brought devastating pain and grief to families. Families of overdose victims like those of Arlene Lastkaub and Christine Dobbs are passionately advocating for this government to properly recognize this public health crisis. Their sons, Jesse and Adam, are just two of the 29 known deaths linked to fentanyl in Manitoba last year. In light of their powerful stories this morning, will the Minister of Health move to recognize the scope and immediacy of this problem in Manitoba and declare a public health state of emergency?
The Honourable Minister of Health.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I appreciate the question from my friend from Concordia. It's a very serious issue, and having spoken with loved ones who have lost children or other adults in their families due to addiction, I think we all feel the heartache and the empathy for those individuals. I appreciated the comments from the Federal Minister of Health, who has asked all health departments to come together for a summit on the issue of opiates in Ottawa next month. We have agreed to that along with other provincial governments. We look forward to a national strategy to deal with what is clearly a significant issue, Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Concordia on a supplementary question.
Indeed, Madam Speaker, we're pleased that the federal government is now at the table, but as the family said this morning, this government shouldn't wait for the federal government to act. There are things that can be done now. These advocates are saying the most important tool that we have against fentanyl is public awareness and proper education on overdose response. By declaring it a public health emergency, this minister could move immediately to increasing access to naloxone kits so that everyone is able to administer the life-saving antidote. Will the health minister mandate that naloxone kits must be available over the counter at all pharmacies and be distributed at shelters, hospitals, schools, and community-based addiction centers?
The Honourable Minister of Health.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and certainly we have already committed to increasing the distribution of naloxone kits, Madam Speaker. Education is always an important part of ensuring that young people and adults have the information that they have. We are certainly concerned that many of those who are taking the dangerous drugs, not only opiates but other drugs that are on the streets, don't always know what it is that they are taking, don't always know what the effect of it is, Madam Speaker. We certainly have health officials who are providing information in a number of different ways, but I do think we will need a coordinated strategy. It's something that is supported by governments across Canada, whether they are New Democratic governments in Alberta, whether they are Liberal governments in Ontario, or a Progressive Conservative government in Manitoba. We all believe there needs to be a coordinated response, Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Concordia on a final supplementary.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. We've heard time and time again from families that the resources for addictions treatment are stretched to the breaking point all over Manitoba. In Selkirk, for instance, the wait for drug users has recently increased to nearly 6 months due to a lack of staff. Addicts are seeking help, and they're directed to an already overwhelmed counselors in towns miles away. These people are asking for help, and they don't have 6 months to wait around. Will the minister agree to expand resources and make it easier for people struggling with addictions to get the life-saving treatment and follow-up that they're asking for?
The Honourable Minister of Health.
Madam Speaker, there is no doubt that over the last many years, more than a decade, the resources that are needed to deal with issues of addictions and mental health, and those are often correlated, have not kept up to the demand, have not kept up to the significant problems. That is something that didn't happen over the last 17 years, and there is no doubt that there is a stress and a strain on the resources as a result of the demand not being fully met by the previous government. We have committed to ensuring that there is a strategy that coordinates both of those together. We will fulfill that commitment and look for better ways to use the resources that we have to help those who need the help, Madam Speaker.